am doing a reading marathon. I know it's book two marathon right now, but I'm not doing that because I didn't prepare. I don't have books, and I'm not ready for it. Yesterday, I filmed a review of Pepped Up by Allie Dean.
Hello all, my name's Blair.
So there's five books, and there's one coming out. The fifth book is coming out soon, and that's finishing out the series. And I read the first one yesterday. I read Pepped Up and reviewed it, and I'm going to be showing you that soon. But I just wanted to tell you, after that review, that's gonna be spoilers for the rest of the series. So if you have not read the first book, once I go into the second book, you wanna leave. Just wanna make sure you don't get spoiled. So without further ado, here is the review of Pepped Up by Allie Dean. Is July's Mark My Words book. Last month I read Darkness of Light, and Mark My Words publicity sent it to me, and I didn't get to read it before, so it was in July's wrap-up, but it's gonna be in August's wrap-up. But it's a really good book. So basically this book is about a cross-country runner named Pepper, and she, like, we get to see her running and stuff, and it's her life, and she's had this friend named Jace, who's been like her best friend for like her entire life. She's kind of separated from him in like high school life, but like when they hang out for dinner and stuff, they're like brother and sister. And she never really thought that he liked her, but during this book we start to see that he actually cares for her more than just a sister way. And she gets really frustrated because she tries to, you know, let him in, and they try to be more, but he isn't letting himself, like, fall in love with her. So it's all about that, and there's also another boy involved, so it's kind of a love triangle, but it's really, really good. If you like cross country, like me, I'm a runner, I really like this book. It was very inspiring. It makes me want to go and run and, like, try to win, because in this book she's, like, really a phenomenal runner. And so it was cool to see her perspective on running and what she feels when she runs. So yeah, that's all I have to say about this book without spoiling you. I gave this book 4 out of 5 stars. It was really good, but it was okay. You know what I'm saying? It was good, but it wasn't phenomenal. So that's why I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. Spoilers. Okay, so I really, really enjoyed this book. I got really frustrated with Jace, how he was, you know, going back and forth, and I hated that he dealt drugs. Like, seriously, bro, seriously, you have everything, and you're gonna come here and ruin it, and then try to drag Pepper into it, and then just drop her. Ugh, ugh. And I can't wait for the next book, because I want to see their relationship, because, like, I was rooting for them, but I was also rooting for Ryan and Pepper, and so it was just very, like, I didn't know what to do. I really liked Zoe and the rest of the cross-country team. I thought they were really funny, and I liked how they always supported her. And one of my favorite parts was when she was at regionals, and like she fell down, but she kept getting up, and she kept wanting to win, and she did, and I was so happy when she won. The way she viewed running was very positive. She was like, this feels good. Everything that is involved, the muscles aching, the not being able to breathe, like, it was good and it felt good, and I've never viewed it like that, so I'm gonna use this book to bring a new perspective to cross country. If you guys didn't know, I'm a runner. I run cross country. I don't run track because I do theater stuff during the spring, but cross country is pretty great. I really like it. It's definitely like a team thing. You don't see people like getting all mean towards each other and pushing each other down, or at least where I live. So it's all about like working hard to be better and like beating yourself. It's not about beating others, really. I mean, the really good runners it is, but like for me it's more about beating yourself and getting better every race. And one race I had a side ache and it was so terrible, I like walked, but I was jogging. It wasn't like I was actually running a race pace, and I got like last, and I didn't beat my time at all. I added like 3 minutes onto my time, and in cross country time, that is a lot. If you're a runner, I definitely recommend this book. It will definitely get you up off your butt. It makes me feel like I could go run right now, and I'm actually going to later. I have cross country practice, but yeah, I really enjoyed this book, Mark My Words. I emailed Mark My Words. I really want to be sent the second, third, and fourth one. I really hope I can get them, because it kind of left me hanging at the end of this book, and I really, really, really want to read more about the relationship between Jace and Pepper. I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! I hope you enjoyed that review of Pepped Up. I'm back. I'm from the beginning of the video. So now I'm going to review the second book in the series, which is All Pepped Up. And I didn't realize that the reason why it's like Pepped Up is because her name's Pepper, and it took me a while. But just a reminder, if you have not read the first book, then you want to leave now. You're probably gone because I just showed you the spoilers from the first book, but this is going to be spoilers for the first book, not for the second book. We're going to start with non-spoilery for the second book. It's all about Jace and Pepper finally got together, and I was so happy. They are so cute together. I felt like, you know when you go see a movie and the second one, like you have such high expectations, the first one was so good, and you read the second one or you watch the second one and it's just not as good, it's just like okay, mediocre, like Spider-Man. It's just that the second book was really good, it was good, I liked how it continued on, but these books are only like 190 pages each, so it's very short books. I mean, I read it in like 5 hours, so actually probably like 3. That's it for non-spoilery. If you have not read the second book, then you want to leave. Spoilery! The author let us understand that, like, Jace was, you know, failing her up in the downtown area in the beginning of the book, but then we don't get to see them doing the diddly-hoo later. Like, she doesn't explain it, and so I'm thinking maybe they didn't do the diddly-hoo. I don't know. It's confusing me. It's confusing me. The words just, I'm very confused. I liked how she got her spunk back with running. There's not much I can say. It's a really good book. I'd probably give this one 3.5 stars. I gave the first book 4 stars. This is probably 3.5 stars. She's in track, which I found less interesting because I'm not in track. And that's all I have to say about this book. Once I finish the third book, I'll tell you about it. Say hi to future Blair. Woo! Hey. Hi. So, it was goth day at Color Guard, and I just read Pepped Up and Ready by Allie Dean, which is the third book in the Pepper Jones collection. As I explained previously in this video, I read the first book and reviewed it. Then I read the second one and reviewed it. And now I read the third one and I'm going to review it for you right now. Disclaimer, if you have not read the first or second book, then you want to leave right now because the third book is going to spoil the second book and the first book. So I've been obsessed with this song. Are you ready? She's kinda hot though. Yeah, she's kinda hot though. My chick is telling me I got crazy dreams. She's also saying I got low self-esteem. She's kinda hot though. Yeah, she's kinda hot though. So, in the first book, we get to know Pepper, we know that she's falling in love with Jace, she's always been in love with Jace, and then they finally get together at the end. Then, in the second book, they finally get together, but there's, like, jealous girls who are coming and, like, ruining, Pepper's life a little bit. She's having a rough time. And then in the third book, that still happens, but Pepper feels so much pressure from, the second book because she won nationals. And she injures herself. She gets like edema in her left leg, like bone edema, and then she has really bad shin splints in her right leg, and she is so scared that she can't run. And the reason why she gets hurt is because she goes to weightlifting 3 days a week, and then she runs like 3 times a day, and she just kept pushing herself, and then she was hurt for a long time, and then a lot of bad things happen. But the nice thing is, like, Pepper doubts Jace and her's relationship, but then at the end they're kind of like, we can get through it, we can get through it, and she, it's just, it's so good. Spoilery! Okay, so I'm all good with being an independent woman, but I really, really liked how Jace was always there for Pepper, and then when she when she broke her arm, I was like, no, no, no. And I didn't expect it to be Savannah. I didn't see it coming. I thought it was Clayton. And it was just like, there was a lot of surprises in this book.
Really? Camille?
I liked this one better than the second one. If I would rank them, I'd go book one, three, then two. For now, I haven't read the fourth and fifth one yet, but I'm going to soon, and I'm hoping that Ashley from Mark My Words will send it to me. I'd give this book 3.75 stars. I want to give it 4, but I don't want to say it is as good as the first one. The first one was really, really good. I think I'm going to split up this video into 2 parts. So this is going to be part 1, where I reviewed the first, second, and third book. And the fifth one isn't out yet, so I'm going to do part 2 when I read the fourth and the fifth book. So yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you've read this series, I hope you have since you've got this far into spoilers, but please comment below. I really enjoyed this book. If you're a runner, you'll love it, and I'm definitely going to share it with my running friends. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye!